Okay, so first of all, talk us through this weekend. There was a win last night, but it was in overtime. Was it a tough game?
Yeah, a very tough game last night. Swindon, obviously, over the last few weeks have improved a lot by bringing Nell in. I think he's a very good player, and I think he's made the offence in Swindon very good. And I think they're a very good home team. I think last night took a lock out of us, certainly going into overtime as well for the win. And then I think here tonight, I think obviously we lost Marty in the first period, and then it kind of throws all the lines in a different way. And then I think with the injuries that we've got also, with a lot of key players out, I think the guys were tired tonight, and it's certainly not an excuse, but we at the minute we're just struggling with penalties a little bit. I think over the last four or five games, I can't remember in a season how many times we've had 5-on-3s against us. Like I say, over the last four or five games, we seem to have had about 5 or 6 5-on-3 penalties, and it takes the momentum out of a team when you're killing penalties, and then if guys are getting kicked out of games and different stuff, then it throws all the lines differently than what you've planned for that game. And it just, like I said, it's hard. Then you're juggling lines around, and I think that's the biggest thing where we are at the minute. And I think a lot of luck's not going our way, but it's up to us to change that and turn that around. And the only way that we do that is by working hard, and hopefully we can get some guys back from injury. And unfortunately, what happens when you've got a short bench, and the more guys play, certainly in penalty situations or penalty killing, then they open themselves up for more injuries. And I've got guys that's playing in the lineup now that probably are only 70-80%, but they want to carry on playing and they feel as though they can play, but they're not playing at 100%, and that itself is you've got to give the guys credit for trying to play and trying to do their best, but right now we're just going against us, and it's up to ourselves to work it out, and we'll work our way out of this, but we've just got to try and limit the silly penalties that we're taking. And certainly when you're down there at this position where we are now, for confidence and different stuff, we've got to eliminate them mistakes that we're making and move on and work hard and get out of this.
You've made two new additions to the team this week. Talk us through that. Why those two?
Obviously, bringing Greg in, we just felt he was, since leaving Slough, he was available. And I thought the way that we've gone this year, I think having a guy of Greg's experience could certainly help us. And I spoke with him a few times, and he was more than happy to come in just before the deadline. And like I say, he's going to come in for the rest of the year and help us out. And I think under the current circumstances, the season that we've had, I've never seen anything like this as far as injuries are concerned. It's just one injury after another, and they're not little injuries. They're certainly injuries that guys are having surgery on and different stuff, and I've never seen anything like it. But we have to deal with that, and I think that was a big choice in going with the three goalies for the rest of the year. It's just one of them years that we're having. And then we brought in Martin, obviously. We've had Curtis has played four games all year, and the thing is with Curtis is the best, for me he's the best import in the league, and every year Curtis plays 50-60 games, he'll score 50-60 goals, and right now we're missing that natural goal scorer with Curtis. So we were trying to look and we left it as late as we could to see where we were going to go with Curtis, and Curtis is on the mend, but he's not ready just yet. And with the deadline approaching, we made a move on bringing Martin in. And like you say, there we bring Martin in, and then we lose Joe last night again, and then Curtis is still out, and then we lose Martin tonight. It's just non-stop.